The five richest people in the world.
Number one is Jeff Bezos. In 1994, Jeff Bezos founded Amazon.com in a garage in Seattle, shortly after he resigned from the hedge fund giant Delaware Shaw. In fact, he had originally pitched the idea of an online bookstore to his former boss David Eshal, who wasn't interested. Though Amazon.com originally started out selling books, it has since morphed into a one-stop shop for everything under the sun, and is arguably the world's largest retailer. At any rate, it is hard to dispute its self-description as the Earth's most customer-centric company. 7. Its pattern of constant diversification is evident in some of its unexpected expansions, which include acquiring Whole Foods in 2017 and launching its own branded over-the-counter drugs in February 2018. In 2020, Amazon's share price skyrocketed on the heightened demand for online shopping as lockdowns forced consumers to stay home. Bezos originally took Amazon public in 1997 and went on to become the first man since Bill Gates in 1999 to achieve a net worth of more than $100 billion. Bezos's other projects include aerospace company Blue Origin, The Washington Post, which he purchased in 2013, and the 10,000-year clock, also known as the Long Now. Number 2 is Elon Musk. Elon Musk has had his hands in several different companies over the years. Originally enrolled at Stanford University, Musk deferred his attendance to launch SIP2, one of the earliest online navigation services. A portion of the proceeds from this endeavor was then reinvested to create X.com, an online payment system that later became PayPal. While both of these systems were eventually sold to other companies, Musk has maintained his status as CEO and lead designer of his third project, Space Exploration Technologies, which aims to make space exploration more affordable. In 2004, Musk became a major funder of Tesla Motors, which led to him being retroactively declared a co-founder and his current position as CEO of the electric vehicle company. In addition to its line of electric automobiles, which includes sedans, smart utility vehicles, and the Cybertruck announced in 2019, Tesla also produces energy storage devices, automobile accessories, merchandise, and, through its acquisition of SolarCity in 2016, solar power systems. In 2020, Tesla's stock price experienced an astronomical surge, having risen 705% from the start of the year to mid-December. It joined the S&P 500 that same month, the largest company added thus far. In 2016, Musk founded two more companies, Neuralink and The Boring Company, with him serving as the CEO of the former. Neuralink is developing brain-machine interface devices to help individuals suffering from paralysis and potentially allow users to mentally interact with their computers and mobile devices. The Boring Company, meanwhile, develops boring machines for the purpose of drilling tunnels for underground public transportation systems, which would mitigate traffic congestion in major cities. It also sold a handheld flamethrower. Number 3. Is Bernard Arnault. French national Bernard Arnault is the chair and CEO of LVMH, the world's largest luxury goods company. This business owns some of the biggest brands on earth, including Louis Vuitton, Hennessy, Marc Jacobs, Sephora, and many more. The majority of his wealth, however, actually comes from his massive stake in Christian Dior SE, the holding company that controls 41.2% of LVMH. His shares in Christian Dior SE, plus an additional 6.2% in LVMH, are held through his family-owned holding company group Arnault Southeastern Engineer by training. Arnault's business chops became apparent while working for his father's construction firm, Ferret Salvinol, which he would take control of in 1971. He later converted Ferret Salvinol to a real estate company named Ferrinol Inc. in 1979. Arnaud remained Ferrinol's chair for another 6 years, until he acquired and reorganized luxury goods maker Financière Agage in 1984, eventually selling all of its holdings other than Christian Dior and Le Bon Marché. He was invited to invest in LVMH in 1987 and became the majority shareholder, chair of the board, and CEO of the company 2 years later. Number 4 is Bill Gates. While attending Harvard University in 1975, Bill Gates went to work alongside his childhood friend Paul Allen to develop new software for the original microcomputers. Following this project's success, Gates dropped out of Harvard in his junior year and went on to found Microsoft with Allen. In addition to being the largest software company in the world, Microsoft also produces its own line of personal computers, publishes books through Microsoft Press, provides email services through its Exchange server, and sells video game systems and associated peripheral devices. Originally Microsoft's chief software architect, Gates later transitioned to the role of the chair in 2008. He had joined Berkshire Hathaway's board in 2004. He later stepped down from both boards on March 13, 2020. In 2000, Gates' two philanthropic organizations, the William H. Gates Foundation and the Gates Learning Foundation, were merged to create the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, of which he and his ex-wife, Melinda Gates, are co-chairs. Through the foundation, he has spent billions to fight polio and malaria. Additionally, he pledged $50 million in 2014 to help fight Ebola. In 2020, the foundation promised to spend $300 million to combat the COVID-19 pandemic. In 2010, alongside Warren Buffett, Bill Gates launched the Giving Pledge, a campaign encouraging rich individuals to commit to donating the majority of their wealth to philanthropic causes. Number 5 is Mark Zuckerberg. Mark Zuckerberg first developed Facebook alongside fellow students Eduardo Severin, Dustin Moskovitz, and Chris Hughes while attending Harvard University in 2004. As Facebook began to be used at other universities, Zuckerberg dropped out of Harvard to focus entirely on his growing business. Today, Zuckerberg is the CEO and chair of Facebook, which had more than 2.8 billion monthly active users as of Q3 2020. Facebook is the world's largest social networking service, enabling its users to create a personal profile, connect with friends and family, join or create groups, and much more. As the website is free to use, most of the company's revenue is generated through advertising. Facebook is also host to several other brands, including photo sharing app Instagram, which it acquired in 2012, cross-platform mobile messaging service WhatsApp, and virtual reality headset producer Oculus, both acquired in 2014. Workplace, its enterprise connectivity platform. Portal, its line of video calling devices. And Novi, its digital wallet for the Deem payment system.